can't quite jump up in it. Now, criminy. That thing came out of nowhere. Did you? It looked like it just popped up out of the ground. Good morning, everybody. It's a beautiful day here on whatever this planet is that I have crash-landed on. The sun is just rising in the morning, and what better way to enjoy the morning than with a nice cup of coffee? Ah, cave bean coffee. The closest thing you can get to an earth-grown blend, but it'll do. Sunrise here on this planet is just beautiful and a little bright. After all, it is a sun. But this scenery is just magnificent. I could not have been blessed to have crashed on a more beautiful planet, one full of danger and death and drones in the sky trying to kill me. But beautiful, nonetheless. And what a more magnificent way to enjoy it than from atop my own private bunker, built by myself in hopes of brutally murdering anything that comes nearby. All right, welcome back to Empyrion Galactic Survival. I'm KnowItAllDM, and I want to thank you for joining me today. So, last time on Empyrion, we finished up the bunker and finally got our defenses in place with this giant autocannon and a couple of point defense turrets. And I am glad that I have this bunker because, well, the drone attacks won't stop coming. So, nice and safe in my bunker, I've run into a conundrum. I need food, and going out and murdering the local wildlife, while satisfying, is not as eco-friendly as it could be. So I've decided to take more steps to be more eco-friendly in this time of death and destruction. So, in order to do that, I've decided to plant a garden. And I figure right here along this side is a perfect place for some gardening. So, I'm going to go ahead and I am going to take out some of the side walls here. I know it leaves my base a little less defended, but I think in the end it'll be better. Now I will put some more defenses over around the garden, but for now it'll stay open. So I have ready some growing plots, a couple of steel blocks, and a grow light. Ignore those. Those were meant to be put away, but never were. So I'm going to go ahead and put these where they need to go. First, I want this there, and then out here, there. Just like that. Except for it needs to be one higher, so that's actually wrong. Give me more steel blocks. I've got more steel blocks. I have some steel blocks here. I am horrible at this game, apparently, because I completely screwed up that awesome way that was going. But anyway, yes, I need those to go up here. Right there. Okay, so that I can actually put back. Can I get some more hardened steel blocks? I thought I had some hardened steel blocks, but I'm going to put them back over here. I'm rambling now, but that's okay. I do that when I get excited. There we go, hardened steel blocks. Okay, let me go ahead and put this back right here. Wall, there we go. Now, I've been playing a little bit on a secondary save just to test some things out, and I figured out some things that I didn't know that, you know, might help me in this game. Specifically, the ease at which growing crops is attained. Alright, now... What? Wait. I'm one short. Come here. No. Hold on. I need rock dust, spoiled food, metal plates. There we go. One more. I totally didn't mess that up at all. Anyway, ignore me. So, this is the longest process here. So while that's working up, I'm going to go ahead and throw down the grow light up here. Bada bing, bada boom. There we go. We've got the grow light up. Next, I need to plant some seeds. Let me go ahead and grab this plot over here, and I'll put that back down where it needs to go. Right there. All right. Now, nice if I could put some walls there, but I can't because of these here. But actually, well, okay, I took them out so that I could put the plants there. That's what I did. Okay, anyway, yeah, so I've got these planted. Next, I'm going to plant some seeds. Let's put the coffee away. I've had enough coffee for today, if you couldn't tell by my talking. Okay, so let's plant. I want some pumpkins and some aloe and a couple of corn plots, some potatoes. They're called durans, but they're potatoes. Gotta have the space coffee, you know, gotta have the space coffee. And then wheat. So I'm gonna plant wheat here, there, and there. And there we go, we've got some crops planted. Now the next thing is to secure this area from attacks and the like. So let's go ahead and build up a few more hardened blocks. And I'm gonna go ahead and enclose this entire area so that it is, that's actually perfect. Maybe not perfect, but close enough to perfect. And I want to go ahead and make a door. Now, one thing that I was playing with, you remember the elevators that were in the MS Titan? I can build some of those, and those are actually really cool when you use them in the base. So, not in this bunker, which I'm going to leave this bunker as it is, but I'm going to build another base probably out that direction. I'm going to put a bridge from here across to there and build a base over there. I'll probably build the base first. But I'm going to use this as a primary resource gathering for to get metal and stuff from the Titan and over there. And where was that? Iron deposit over here. We've got two iron deposits there. Actually, why would I build over here when I can go ahead and build over here near the silicon deposit, near those, over there? Yeah, I think I'm going to put my main base right here in this area. I hope that that's a jungle area. I think it's a jungle area. But anyway, jungle areas are good for living because they produce the things required to make small med kits, which is really nice. It's got a little bit more dangerous enemies in there, but the rewards outweigh the risk, or, you know. So, all right, I'm going to put this door here so I can come on out to my plant area And then I'm going to start building some walls. Oh, I'm going to need to get rid of those so I can have now these I'm going to need like that and build all the way up. Can I not go one more up? Oh, I don't know why it wouldn't let me, but okay, I got up. And then start putting walls here. That was one way to do it. All right, walls. Walls. No, I need it like that. Okay. Let's go ahead and just put these here. And then there. There. And what? Wait, that's just a graphical glitch apparently. Okay. There, there, and there. All right, and then we're going to go ahead and do this and that and that. All right, so now we've got a little garden. Now, I think I'm going to leave this garden area open to the sky because I like the way it looks. If I have problems, I might enclose it in. Actually, nah, I like the way it looks. But if I have problems, I'll enclose it in. But for now, we're just going to leave it like that. I wish I could close that part off. Like, put the walls back here. But then I wouldn't be able to fit that there, and it would be all weird. And anyway, yeah. So, that's going to be the bunker. Now, these plants grow at different rates. The fastest plant to grow is going to be this right here. As you saw, it just pop up. That is the durin. That is the aloe. Yeah. So the aloe and the durin are the two fastest ones. Then it's the pumpkin, the coffee, and the wheat and corn are all about the same. So in a minute, I'm going to go grab some of those. Now, the next thing I want to do is get ready to start building the bigger base. Now, in order to do that, I'm going to need a lot of wood. And I mean a lot, because I'm going to build this base out of wood. My computer's making noises, so I hope you didn't hear that. So I'm going to build as many wooden blocks as I possibly can. After all, that's the only thing, just about, that wooden planks are good for. Now, I'm probably not going to be able to build this many. I'm just going to throw, 1,000 in there and see what I can do. Because it requires 4. I'm not going to be able to build that many. It requires 4 wood planks per block, and I had 2,000-ish. So I'll be able to build 500. Now, another thing about building out this direction is that the drones are coming from that way. So I'm going to need to have some sort of defenses at that base against drones as well. So I'm thinking just a couple of these will be good. I don't need these little things. And of course, when I head over there, I will turn this base off to save power. Because nothing should attack the base while I'm not here. So I'll just use this as a bunker, as a fallback point at that point, if my main base gets, destroyed, because it'll just be made of wood. The only protection it will have will be the turrets. Now, I also just now had a thought. If I built underground, if I had this bunker, took out a couple of these planks and dug down, I could have an actual bunker underneath the bunker. That would be cool. I might end up doing that. Anyway, that'll be for a later date. So I'm going to get these wood blocks built up, and I'm going to go ahead and get the starter base set up, and I'm going to go over there, and once I get over there to start building the actual base, I will be back. All right, so I'm back. So we've got the aloe ready to harvest, and soon the durans should be ready, as should the coffee beans. The rest of this will be just a little bit longer, but as you can see, it doesn't take terrible amounts of time. Now, I've got the basic starter for a base set up. So I'm also going to take an extra O2 generator and an extra water generator. Even though there's no water source here, there is a little lake over here that I might set up the generators at, because it's a little bit closer than coming all the way back over here across the mountains. So once I get a hovercraft, I can just hover over there and hover back. Now, I do plan on getting a hovercraft, possibly next episode. But for now, I am going to go ahead and walk on over there, and I'll be back if anything interesting happens. All right, so we're over here next to the silicon deposit, and I think I want to build in this clearing here so that I don't disrupt any of the trees around. Now, I might end up having to take some trees down, of course, but for now, I think building here will be an optimal spot. So, let's see if I can get one of the flattest areas to start building. If I start here, put this down. Okay. Can you go down there? Sort of. You see, if it's not really flat, it doesn't like it when I build things. Actually, was it flat or the grass? I think it was the grass that was doing it. So if I do this. Okay. If I go down rather quickly and then click it once it's down. Okay. There. Perfect. All right. That's a good starter block. Now, let's get the base of the floor built. Now, this is going to be a rather large base. Now, I think that's as far this way as I can come there. There's going to be a few areas that the grass sticks through, but that's okay. All right. And then over here. Now, this base is going to be basically a home rather than just a survival shelter like that other base was, which I have labeled the other base the bunker. And you can't see it here, but on the map, I called it the bunker. I actually figured out how you can rename things, and I'll show you with this base how to do that. Now, I don't want it to be perfectly symmetrical. I'm going to have it, you know, kind of off, but all right. And I'm definitely going to need more wooden blocks, but I think I'm going to get them from over at the bunker, because I'm hoping that spending time away from that area will cause trees to respawn. Now, I'm going to go ahead and start by lining this area. I want all the walls to basically be where I can build on the inside. So I'm going to have exterior walls like this so that I can put walls up out here and still build up right next to the wall. This is the only way that I've figured out how to make it so that I can build. Wrong button. There. Whoa. What? Okay. Where I can build right next to the walls. So... this is basically what I'm going to have to do. Now, will this go all the way over to here? We'll see. And it does. Okay. Good, good. Now, this area... This area? Nah, I'm going to have a different area. Somewhere I'm going to actually build a garden over here as well. But I think I'm going to have the garden actually a separate structure. Possibly made of windows and the like. Windows being glass. I'm not entirely sure how that works. But, alright, and, yeah. Alright, so for now, this is going to be the house. Now, I'm going to have multiple rooms in here, that's why I made it so big, but to start with, this is going to be my house. Now, I want this... to be one of these. Yeah, perfect. So that I can put the door right here. And there we go. I have the first part of the house built. Now, what I'm planning on doing is I'm going to have a room where the functionality is, and then a room for aesthetics. So I think I'm going to have the functionality room be, let's see, is that where, yeah, over here. All I need there is this. And I'm going to need an O2 station where I can fill up the O2. And I'm going to need my clone chamber over here. And then that is going to be that room. So there I can go ahead and enclose this. I'm going to have one wall there. This corner is going to be like that. And then here, I'm going to have a door here. And I'm going to have another door here so that I can come in, do the O2, do the fabrication, and when I respawn, I'll respawn here. Now, the food processor and the refrigerator are going to go in a kitchen, and all of these are going to go in their own, room, which I'm thinking I'm going to put above this area. So what I'm going to want to do, now this room here is going to definitely have to be too high. So let me go ahead and make this room too high. And I don't mean excessively high, I mean like this. And that. And that. And then over here as well. I'm going to have it come out over here. And here. And lastly, there. So now the room is two stories high, and I'm just going to go ahead and throw a roof on it. Like that. Now, eventually I'm going to fill out the outer wall and have a double layer there, but for now I'm just going to leave it as it is. Now, the next room I'm going to have is going to be the entryway, which is going to basically be the living room. So what I'm going to do is do this. How far over do I want it? I want it to here. And then that and that. This is going to be the entry room, living room, habitation room. This over here is going to be the kitchen. So I'm going to go ahead and put in the food processor. Now I may want to put those walls over on the interior here so I can have more room in the kitchen, because this is going to be spacious enough as it is. So let me go ahead and I'm going to go ahead and put the food processor in, but I'm going to put it, let's see, should I put it here? Yeah, food processor, refrigerator, and then here's some places that I'll put some deco things, counters and the like. And these will be used later. All right, so now that I've got those, now the rest of this area of the house is going to be only one story high. So let me go ahead and fill in the rest of this with ceilings. Now, I think in order to get it not to collapse, I need to have interior walls like that. And I don't know what is going to stop it from collapsing or what caused collapses in the past, but for now I'm going to build it this way. Thank you. Okay, and hopefully once I get this last one in, no collapse. Awesome. All right, now that I have that, this room is going to be probably a bedroom. And then I'm going to have an entire second floor up here. Now, what I'm going to want to do is go ahead and fill in. Can I not fill in that block there? That's because of the wall. Okay. So, there. Now I should be able to put a block there. All right, perfect. So, now here, I think, alright, I know what I want to do, ha, I am going to put don't know why it did that, but okay. Let's see, what was I gonna do? Yes, okay. So here is going to be... yeah, let me do that. Okay. All right, now here is, I'm sorry, I am totally not entertaining. Tell you what, I'm gonna go ahead and get a lot of this stuff finished up, and I will be back once I need to get more stuff. Okay, so I've got the bottom floor pretty much set up the way that I will want it. Let me get a brighter light. There we go. So you'll come into here, and this will be the living room. In here, you'll have the kitchen with some appliances and some other stuff. I've got a storage room back here, and the primary functionality, the fabricator and the O2 station in here. And what I'm going to do is right here is going to be an elevator to take you up to this floor. Now with the jetpack, I don't really need an elevator, but I don't always want to use the jetpack, and going down, I don't want to have to just fall. Also, I'm probably going to have a third and maybe even a fourth level eventually, so an elevator would be preferable. Now, on this level, I'm going to end up I'm going to end up putting the bedroom and other things up on this level. The bedroom will be over here, probably over here. There's really no good scenery. The best scenery we've got is over there with the Titan, and that's going to be deconstructed anyway. But this is actually not a bad vista. So, okay, I'll put the bedroom over here, outlooking this area. And then over here, in this area, will be where I put all of the fuel and stuff like that that runs the base. So that's my plans for this. Now, I've got to go back and get some... I actually got to get fuel for the base, but I'm going to go ahead and build up the second floor, then I'm going to go do that, and when I come back, I should have almost a finished base. Okay, so I'm back at the bunker, and all of my vegetables and everything have grown. So I can harvest everything, and as you can see, the stuff will regrow even after being harvested. So now there's a lot that you can do with all of these. With the wheat, you can make flour, and then you can make dino stew, which is really good apparently, and 200 food, 30 health. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. But with the corn, instead of making, you know, food things, I'm going to make raw plastic materials. Now, I can only make one because I only have one rock dust, but I can go ahead and make another so I can make two raw plastic materials. Now, what the raw plastic materials are good for are creating these, which I should have brought more wood planks from the other thing so I could actually, you know, make these. These are just decorations that you can put around the house, but they look nice. And I know I'm definitely going to want to put some in the house. So I'm gonna get more wood planks and build those up. But what I came here for was fuel for the new base. Now I'm gonna go ahead and bring some of these, more wooden blocks, stairs. Actually, I don't need stairs, but I am going to go ahead and make some elevator blocks. Now, I probably don't need that many, but, you know, why not? Oh, I need a big medic station to put there, too. I forgot about the medic station. And let's see, what else am I gonna need? More doors. And I really need to eat because I'm hungry. Alright. And what else? I'm going to need a couple more lights. And then after we get that, I think we'll be good to start living in the new base. Now I'm going to want to transfer some of this stuff over. I'm going to want some O2 bottles. I don't know what hydrogen fuel packs are used for yet, but I will figure that out eventually. Yeah, we'll need to go ahead and take some water jugs and O2 because we're going to need that. And let's go ahead and take all of our tools because we're going to be away from this base. We're going to start actually living there. The survival constructor, I think I'm going to leave here along with the work light. Oh, there's another light. Huh, I didn't need that. And these I'm probably just going to leave over here. All right, we've got the elevators. And what I'm going to do is once I get the hovercraft built, I'm going to use that to transport all of this. Although I might use up a good chunk of this in building the hovercraft. In fact, I'm probably not going to have enough stuff to build the hovercraft completely. But, you know, we'll see. All right, we're almost back over to the house. And I think that's just what I'm going to call it, the house. And as you can see, I've got some stuff done on the top up there. I've got this little balcony out here that I've got for the bedroom. And I can't quite jump up in it. Now, criminy! That thing came out of nowhere. Did you? It looked like it just popped up out of the ground. Gosh, scared the crud out of me. All right, well. Yeah, you see, that's why I need turrets on the top of my building. But anyway, I'm going to need to put a door on that other side because having the door facing away from the main path isn't going to be very useful. So I think right here, I'm going to have... Wait, did I just... Okay, good. I've got those two there. I'm going to need to put a door there. And what I'm going to do is... Okay. Four. And five. Right there. So I can come in and elevate up. And that'll be the back door. And since I'll be using it specifically to get to the cargo, it works. Now here, I'm going to put door here, and then elevator here and there, and then over here is where I'm going to put all that stuff. Let me go ahead and grab that. Thing is, there's a hole there. I keep thinking, but I can just walk right over the hole because it's an elevator. Generator and this. Alright. And here. Alright, I'm gonna put door there. And here. And then over here, we're going to have... the fill-up stations. So let's put this... O2 will be here. This will be here. And then that will be there in the corner. Now, I'm going to have this. Come from there to here. All right, let's go ahead. Do that. And that, and we should be able to power the base. All right. Beautiful. All right. Now. Let's see. Over here, we've got all these. We've got the oxygen station. Now, I put a light out here and in here. And I put a light in here. I didn't put one in here or over here, because these will provide enough light for this room at night. And this is the cargo area. You don't really need light in the cargo area, but just in case, let me put a light right there. Now, on the exterior, I think here I am going to need a light. Dang it. Okay. Well, let's see. I take off the jetpack. I can get up to here just fine with just that. So if I put a wall here. Really? There's a spider right outside my base? That's no fun. Damage anything? No. Doesn't look like he damaged anything. Apart from me, that is. Alright, so the medic station. The medic station, you would think, would need to go in here. But there's no room for it. Because I didn't think about that. The medic station is a too high, so it's going to definitely need to go in here. So what I'm going to do Let's see. Okay. What to do? See, this is a conundrum that I didn't think about. Okay. What I'm going to need to do is I'm going to have to renovate some things. So I'm going to get some stuff done real quick, and then I'll be back once I get it fixed. All right, and we're back, and we have power. Now that we have power, It's metal components. Okay, so now that we have power, I can show you what I've done so far. So, in here, this will be the bedroom. The bed, I'm not entirely sure how big it is. I might extend the bedroom into here as well and just have this be like, have this be a observation area and have this be the bedroom. Then we have this little deck area up here that I'm not entirely sure what I'm going to be doing with. Then up here, we've got the roof with elevator access so that when I put the turret up here, it will be accessed from there. Now, I accidentally made a second one of these rather than an oxygen tank. So I'm going to put an oxygen tank over here in this corner. And this room, I'm not entirely sure what I'm going to do with either. But yeah, this is the upstairs. And we've got the downstairs down here, which I extended this out to put this in. So we've got the medic station here, which I'm not entirely sure what, how the medic station works. Okay, so you just stand in it and your health goes up. That's cool. All right, well, that's nice. All right, so the next thing that we need to do is we're going to need to bring the stuff from the other base over to here. But I think that's going to be it for this episode because we are running kind of short on time. But I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. If you did, hit that like button for me. If you want to see more Empyrion Galactic Survival, go ahead and subscribe. And if you have anything else to say, leave a comment. All right, everybody. Y'all have a good day now.